One of the things we'd like to do is have a way of comparing algorithms in terms of the time it takes to run them without actually having to go and do all the hard work of running them. Instead, what we're going to try to do is analyze what the running time is in kind of more of an abstract model of computation. To do that is very difficult. To get the exact timing information without actually running it is something that we probably can't do. But we can make a series of simplifying assumptions. These simplifying assumptions will allow us to do an analysis that is more tractable. So here's some of the assumptions that we're going to make. So we count a simple statement, something like x equals x plus 1, as something that takes 1 unit of time. And we're going to count up the number of units of time an algorithm takes to run. The second simplifying assumption we'll make is that the time it takes to execute a pair of statements, or 3 statements, or 10 statements, in sequence is the sum of the times that it takes to execute each of the individual statements. So this ignores a lot of issues that go on in the architecture of the computer, things like pipelining and caching, that make this actually not true in practice. But we're going to hope that it's a good enough approximation of reality. So measuring the time that takes to run something like an if statement, we're going to imagine that there's the time that it takes to execute the condition evaluation, and then the time that it takes to actually execute the statement. So this would be essentially 2 units of time. So it follows from these assumptions that the running time for a loop is going to be equal to the time it takes for the body of the loop to run times the number of times it's repeated, the number of iterations. So a block of statements like this, where I takes on a set of values 0, 1, 2, and 3 and prints each one, we'll say that this takes 4 units of time because this unit statement is repeated 4 times. So let's see if you're getting the hang of this. So here's a little quiz. How many units of time will this little block of Python code take to run? You can fill in your numerical answer in the box.